With the recently released iOS 15 and iPadOS 15, you can generate a link to a FaceTime chat that can be shared anywhere and allow anyone to join a FaceTime session with you, even if they don't have an Apple device. Friends and family members who do not have an Apple account can log into a FaceTime call using a web browser on any non-Apple device, such as a Windows PC or an Android phone, using this new link feature. FaceTime is now a platform-free video service, although you must be an iOS or Mac user to initiate the FaceTime call and submit the link, and this is how it works in iOS 15 and iPadOS 15. The first thing you have to do is launch the FaceTime app on your device, and you're going to see there's a new create link button. You then need to give a name to your FaceTime link by pressing this add name button, and now you can simply share the link with whoever you want to add to the video chat by using one of these sharing options like messages or mail or other chat platforms like WhatsApp and Telegram. There's tons of options to choose from, so I'm going to send the link to my Android phone to show you how it works. Now, when you send the link and the receiver clicks on it, they will be taken to a screen where they need to enter their name to join the chat. And once they are connected, they'll also have all the standard FaceTime options like mute their microphone, deactivate the video, switch the camera angle, and leave the call if they don't want to participate anymore. Also, every time someone is trying to join the call, it needs to be let in by the one who created the video chat room. So they're going to receive a notification like this saying that someone is trying to connect. And that's pretty much all you need to know on the new FaceTime feature, which in my opinion is a really great add-on since it doesn't require users to download any additional apps or programs, and they can use whichever device they have to join the room, from PC to Android tablets and phones and so on. So big thumbs up from me. But what do you think of the new FaceTime features? Let me know in the comments down below. Also, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up or share it with someone you think might benefit from it. And if you would like to see some similar tutorials, please subscribe to the channel. And like always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.